today I'm going to start on a carved ring for Tony Woodman. This is the wax blank that I'm going to start with. A lot of this wax is going to have to be removed, but the first thing that I have to do is size the inside of it, and I'm using this ring sizer, this wax ring sizer, to carve out the inside to get it to the size that we need it to be. The next thing that I need to do is to reduce the width so that it's 4 to 5 millimeters, as we've discussed, and I'm going to use this piece, the divider, to score the mark all the way around the ring at the size that we need. This is set to 4.5 millimeters. As I create this scribed line all the way around the wax blank, and once that is done, then I need to remove this excess wax. To do that, I'm going to use a coarse file, and I'm going to just drag the wax across it until I'm down to the proper size. Now that I've reduced the thickness of the wax model, I'm going to then draw my circumference around it so that I can take away the excess around it. I'm going to use my dividers again to mark a line evenly around, all the way around, so I know approximately how much to remove. I'll probably remove more than this, but this will give me a place to start. And once I have that done, then I'm going to take my saw blade I'm going to take my saw blade and remove these corners so that I can start to file the shape. This is just a rough removal of excess wax.
And you're using a wax file, right?
I'm using a regular jeweler's saw blade. This is a 2/0. As long as you don't go too fast, it'll work just fine.
Okay.
I'm trying to keep the wax dust off my pattern. All right, so that's where I'm at now, and it's still pretty rough looking, but it's a little bit closer. Now I'm going to start to use my coarse hand file, half round ring file, to bring this down into shape, and then I'm going to start to round the edges a little bit. All right, now that I have the basic shape filed using the different coarse and fine files, now I'm going to clean it up with sandpaper and take out all of the file marks and continue to refine the shape to what I need to have before I can start carving the letters into it. I'll go through a couple of stages of sandpaper. This is 320, and then I'll do 400, and then I'll do 600, and then I'll polish the wax, and then I'll draw the design on it.
Go.
All right, after I've sanded and shaped the ring, now I'm going to polish it until it's nice and clean and shiny. I've got the design laid out around the circumference of the ring, and I've marked using a Sharpie all of the different areas, the delineation for the letters that I'm going to carve. And now I'm going to take my scribe and create those marks based on the layout of the piece. Right. Once I'm done with the scribing, let me take a little piece of sandpaper here so you can begin to see the marks. Is that the one I want? Yeah. You can start to see the layout, and the marks show up a little bit better. And then I'm going to take my wax carving tool and make those marks a little bit more prominent all the way around the ring.
All right, today I'm going to attach sprues to a ring. I'm heating my little dissecting tool that I've hammered flat into a candle and so I can melt the wax and touch it into the band where I want it. And then I'm going to use an X-Acto knife that I have dedicated to this purpose and cut that off where I want it. I have to do a series of three, about equidistant as I can get it here. And I'm waiting for the wax to solidify before I go on to the next piece. One more to go. And once I have this triangle set up, this will be the gate for the molten metal to enter and for the wax model to leave after I've put it into the mold material. Now I have to go in then and connect all of these pieces. And I'm just going to drip some wax in there and build it up until they're all connected so that I have a completed gate. Again, for the wax to leave the mold and the metal to enter the mold. And once that's done, then I'm going to attach the ring to the base, put the flask around it, sorry about that, and then put the mold material inside the flask.
All right, to do the investing, I measure out the water that I need for the flask size, and I pour the investing powder into the bowl with the water, and then I start a process of mixing. I have to mix this for 3 minutes, making sure that I break up all of the lumps in the process and scrape the sides frequently. All right, I'm painting investment around the outside design to help keep any bubbles from forming in the areas that I need.
Can you bring it this way just so we'll be able to go?
That I need a nice clean cast. So in the meantime, what you're hearing in the background is the investment in the vacuum table, and that is drawing all of the extra air out of it, again, to keep the bubbles to a minimum. And if you look at the investment now, it's rising up, and the air is coming out of it. Alright, I've placed the flask around the base to hold the investment, and I'm putting tape around the outside edge, which will act as a collar for the investment as it goes back into the vacuum.
Stop.
I'm going to pour the investment into the flask down the side and allow it to fill it up around the wax model of the ring, all the way up to the rim of the flask. And once that's done, I'm going to put the whole thing back into the vacuum to draw the air out of it one more time.
Okay, so.
All right, the vacuuming is done, so now I'm going to set this aside to sit for the next 24 hours, and tomorrow we'll put it in the kiln and be ready to cast it. All right, I'm going to pour the metal into a crucible that's been warmed up, and then we're going to use the torch to heat it to the melting point. So you can get the torch a little closer. Don't aim that way, there you go. Aim it just a little bit at an angle. Angle, not too close. There we go. And this is going to take a couple of minutes to bring the silver to a melt point. We're going to put a pinch of flux in the metal as you move the torch away. Move the torch away. There we go. Alright, and then bring it back in. Nice and close. There we go. Alright, the metal is mostly melted, so now I'm going to take the flask out of the kiln. All of the wax from the model has been burnt out, and I'm going to put it into the cradle here. I need a little bit of a spacer because it's a short flask, and I'm going to push the crucible right up next to it, and then I'm going to check the metal one more time. You can probably see that it's pretty molten here. A little bit more of a straight up and down on the... There we go. Alright. And then I'm going to push the lever back on the centrifuge and the pin will drop. And then on your count of three, lift up the torch and turn it off and I'll let this go.
One, two, three.
This is going to spin down for a little bit to continue to force the metal into the mold. And when it's done spinning, then I'm going to remove it from the cradle and set it on a fire brick to cool. Alright, I'm going to take my flask with the silver ring in it, and I'm going to quench it in a bucket of water to break up the investment. It bubbles off most of the investment so I can get to it and remove the ring, which ended up in the bucket. Alright, so let me get that. I forgot to pull my rings off. Hazards of the job. And there we are. And this is what it looks like when it comes out of the investment. It's kind of dirty, full of the mold material, which I'm going to clean up then using toothbrushes and picks to get all of this mold material off of the silver. When I am done with this, I'm going to clean the silver in a mild acid bath called pickle. Right, I'm cutting the sprues off the ring now using my saw blade and a bench pin, and I have to get this lined up. Alright, so I have two of the three cut off already. This will be the last one. And that one's been through. This is the one I need to cut. And now the ring is free of its base. And I'm going to have to take the files and remove the rest of my sprues on the inside of the ring. All right, so I'm going to do this by holding on to it. Let's see if we can get a good view of it. And just removing that metal. And then cleaning up any other scratches that might have occurred in the wax process that I didn't catch. Alright, I've gotten the sprues off the piece and I've taken any nicks out of it with my files, and now I'm running the sandpaper over it in a progression of grits to get it nice and clean. And here we have the piece. It's been patinaed, so the indentations are dark. And let me start here at the beginning. There we go. And here we have this ring with text encircling the whole ring.